standing in the eye of the storm. Ancient philosophy talked about an end of time and a transformation of humanity. And while they could tell us about when this might occur, they really didn't underline why it would occur. Now we know why we are facing our imminent extinction on this planet and coming to those prophecies and making them real. And that is this. We base our world on knowledge. Knowledge is power. Lack of knowledge is lack of power.
Reports as yet. Please stand by for further details. We return you now to your regularly scheduled program.
This is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
This is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
This is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
Simply this, if you don't understand, if you have a misperception of the world, it can kill you.
My name is Gregory Stenstrom. I'm from Delaware County. I'm a father, a family man. I was a former commanding officer and executive officer in the Navy. I'm a veteran of foreign wars. I'm a CEO of my own private company. I'm a data scientist. I'm a forensic computer scientist. I'm an expert in security and fraud. First part of the day, I was a poll watcher in the city of Chester, and I was with just another former U.S. Marine officer, and the two of us were the only GOP poll watchers in the city of Chester. One of the things we saw out in the field was that people, quite a few people had done mail-in ballots, so they came in and they hadn't been updated in the Delaware County database yet. So the process, one of the processes was to give them a provisional ballot, and then they would vote provisionally, and then later on their vote would be sorted out. That didn't happen. I observed, and the gentleman that was with me observed seven different polls where the people were given a regular ballot. So they cast a vote and put it in. You know, we let it happen a few times. You know, we didn't jump all over them. You know, it happened a couple of times. We went up. In all cases, the election judges were very forthcoming, very polite. They apologized. But that somewhat spurred me to go down to the counting center. It's a remote building, not much around it. And I wanted to take a look. I arrived at 6 o'clock with four other gentlemen, again, foreign military. We weren't allowed to get in until 11 o'clock at night, and we had to get some legal help to get us in. So it took us 5 hours to get upstairs. What I saw there was a chain of custody in all cases that was broken. It was broken for the mail-in ballots, the drop-box ballots, the election day USB V-card flash drives. In all cases, the chain of custody and the procedures that were defined by the Delaware County Board of Elections an election process review, were all, they didn't follow one. I couldn't even redline this multi-page document because the entire document would be, they didn't follow any of the procedures.
With every choice and action, a timeline of one's life is drawn forward. And for every possible choice and action that one could make but doesn't, another possible world, another possible self, another possible timeline unfolds in a separate direction that one can never know.
So I personally observed USB V-cards being uploaded to the voting machines by the voting machine warehouse supervisor on multiple occasions. I saw this personally. I brought it to the attention of the deputy sheriff who was there stationed, who was a senior law enforcement officer, and I brought it to the attention of the clerk of elections. I brought it to their attention. I objected, and I said, this person is not being observed. He's not part of the process that I can see, and he's walking in with baggies, which we have pictures of, and it was submitted to, in our affidavits, and he was sticking these USBs into the machines. So I personally witnessed over that happened 24 times, over 24 times. We have multiple other witnesses that saw it, including Democrat poll watchers. On Thursday, it took us 3 days for them to obey the court order that I secured with Leah's help. They got us in there. They got the order for us to get in and watch it, look at the back offices, which were locked for 5 minutes every 2 hours. I went in. I was the first one allowed to go in at 1:30 on Thursday, and then again at 3:30 for 5 minutes. The county solicitor had a stopwatch. On the first time, I was not allowed to touch anything. The second time, I did. What I observed in the locked room in the back office was 70,000 unopened mail-in ballots. They were in boxes of 500, stacked in neatly. The gentleman that came in with me is a Democrat poll watcher, is a forensic pathologist, a very detailed, very dedicated man, and he took meticulous notes as well. And I verified with him, are you seeing what I'm seeing? We both agreed as GOP poll watchers and a Democrat poll watcher that we had witnessed 60 to 70,000. We had a little bit of a disagreement there. So 120,000 mail-in ballots had already been counted, posted, and done. So my question is, where do the 70,000 ballots go? And nobody knows. I think people saw what they wanted to see, and they saw what was intended for them to see. I called it at one point Kabuki Theater. I said it was all designed for us to see it. It was entertaining. There were cameras on it.
The sharing of biased and false news has become all too common on social media. More alarming, some media outlets publish these same fake stories without checking facts first.
The sharing of biased and
false news has become all too common on social media.
More alarming, some media outlets publish these same fake stories.
The problem is that the basic patterns of belief and behavior that are programmed in the subconscious mind came from our teachers, primarily our parents, our family, and our community. We didn't put those programs in there. They're other people's programs. And now neuroscience has told us in the unfolding of our lives, only 5% of our life is controlled by our conscious mind, what we want, and 95% is controlled by the programs. But the programs primarily came from other people.
As a forensic computer scientist, my interest is in the data. Where did it go? Where did the spoilage go? How did the data come in and go out of the system? And literally begged multiple law enforcement agencies. They said, go in. And they said, in order to prove, prove that nothing's happening, you need to either exonerate yourselves in the process or refute what I'm saying, please. It's a very simple process. Just go get the forensic evidence from the computers. It's a simple process. You turn the computer off. It's non-destructive. To do it properly and collect the evidence, you open the computer up. You take a device called a bit blocker. You put it in the hard drive. It's done under the observation of law enforcement officers. They take a forensic image of the drive, put it all back together. It wouldn't have taken more than an hour to image all five machines. That was never done. Lastly, when they said, well, we've got all the forensic records and so forth. We just learned 2 days ago that virtually all chain of custody logs, records, yellow sheets, everything was gone. So we have a situation where we have 100,000 ballots to 120,000 ballots, both mail-in and USB, they're in question. And you can't certify 100,000 votes out of 300,000, then you can't certify Delaware County. And I'm done, and thank you for your time and patience.
And while we are arguing about negotiations and while we are arguing about points, people are going hungry. And we are dismissing their needs as blue state needs, or as bailouts depending on what party you voted for. Hunger has no party. Illness has no party. And when we allow suffering to be alleviated or concentrated based on political affiliation, we are doing a disservice to our entire nation. 5.6 million households with children struggling to put enough food on the table in the last 7 days. Landlords filed at least 43,500 evictions in 17 major cities from March until September. An estimated 13.4 million adults living in rental housing today, nearly one in five renters, were not caught up on rent. Small businesses don't know if they are going to survive or exist in a month, in a week, in January. We cannot afford to wait
for a new administration or another election or a political state of play. We need to get people help now. And the Senate broke. They broke. We are supposed to be here to work for everyday people. We are not supposed to be here to work for political donors or political favors or the powerful. We are here to serve the people who are most vulnerable all the way up to the top. But we start with the people most in need. Our country is going hungry on the week before Thanksgiving, and the Senate broke. I don't care what party you are. It is an abandonment of our responsibilities as elected officials who are charged with acting in the public trust.
You want to get your power back, then you have to look at those subconscious programs, because science has revealed that virtually most of those programs that get in there, 70% or more of those programs, are really leading to limiting, sabotaging beliefs that are self-destructive. And this is why we can't get out of our own way, because we didn't even see we were in our own way.
They've cut it in. Okay. Who does this kind of stuff? Yeah.
It's interesting how it comes right. It's right at.
Yeah.
Pointing right at the limited crack.
Yeah. That is just wild.
Huh. We ought to see if there's sunny right.
Yeah, it's not.